Hello, welcome to Cloud Technologies. Today we are going to see ActiveMQ integration in MuleSoft. And sorry for the late, we are not publishing videos on a regular basis due to project occupation and all. So from now onwards, we will upload videos very frequently. Okay, so in this video series, we are going to see ActiveMQ integration with MuleSoft. Okay, but before that, I would like to introduce you. What is JMS and what is message queue and what are the basic steps and basic topics behind that. Then we will see how we can install ActiveMQ and how we can do the actual integration with the ActiveMQ by using MuleSoft. Okay, let's start. So before we are going to do what is ActiveMQ and MuleSoft integration, let us see what is JMS. So JMS is nothing but Java Messaging Service. So it is a kind of API. It will allow you to send and receive messages from one application to another application. Okay. So the brief about JMS is like, it is a kind of message-oriented middleware. Okay. By using this JMS API, we can send, create, read messages from one system to another system or one location to another location. Okay. So it will support, actually it has two different types of messaging models. One is point to point connection, another one is publish subscribe model, which is again called as a PubSub model. Okay, and if you would like to see what is producer, what is consumer, so JMS producer or publisher, which is nothing but to send and create the message. JMS consumer or subscriber is a client that receives the message. So we have two types. One is to send the message, another one is to receive the message. These two are the two different JMS clients. Okay. So for example, one application is running in India, another application is running in another country, for example USA. So to send a message from one application, I mean India application to USA application, we need to use JMS in a reliable pattern. And if you don't want to lost your message, that is nothing but reliable pattern. So if you would like to apply reliable pattern and asynchronous processing, you will go with JMS. Okay. So as we discussed, it supports two types of messaging models: point to point and publish subscribe model. That is nothing but PubSub model. So the point to point connection is nothing but one to one connection. And JMS and any JMS client or any JMS message provider has two different types of systems. One is queue and another one is topic. So JMS queue is nothing but point to point connection. And in this case, we have only one sender and one receiver. So if we can analyze this diagram, we'll get to know. So for each and every sender, only one receiver will be receive the message. It means like once the sender send a message to queue, only one receiver which is available by that time will receive that message. And there is no timing dependency between the sender and receiver. Also, this is nothing but a FIFO model, like a first in first out model. Whichever the receiver is available at the first time, that will receive the message available in the queue. So that is the brief about queue. Then coming to topic, it is a nothing but one to many model, like PubSub model. It means like once a publisher publish the message into this topic, any number of subscribers can subscribe that message. Okay, just like that, in queue only one receiver will take the message, but in PubSub topic model, any number of subscribers can subscribe to that particular topic and they can receive the copy of particular message. Okay, so it will deliver to all subscriber. What if any subscriber is down or offline by that time when it is receiving? In that case, the topic will hold that message. So once the subscriber is available online again, then that message will be delivered to that particular subscriber. So there will be no message lost. Okay. So also we have two types of messages. One is synchronous and another one is asynchronous. Maybe a couple of you might have aware of it. Just to give you brief, synchronous is nothing but the client will wait for the server to respond the message. Because the client will wait to get that response. In that request response messaging pattern, once we send the request, it is waiting for that reply to be coming on. For example, the telephone call. Like once we dial the number, we will expect someone to pick that call and someone to answer our call, right? In that way, it's a two-way communication, synchronous. Like the client will wait for the response. And in case of asynchronous messaging pattern, the client does not wait for the response from the server, but automatically the event is created. In that case, like for example, email or broadcasting a message, email, in case of email, just we send an email. We are not going to wait for that email response, right? So just like that, it is an asynchronous process. JMS will support, I mean, any MOM, any message oriented middleware or any JMS provider will support both type of messaging patterns, synchronous and asynchronous. And these are the major JMS brokers. We have lot many more, but these are the major JMS brokers which is available in market and which are using in our day-to-day projects. Kafka, RabbitMQ, AnyPointMQ, ActiveMQ, JBassMQ, AWS SQS, Kestrel. And AnyPointMQ, which I have highlighted, this is specific to MuleSoft. Okay. Only MuleSoft Cloud Hub will have this AnyPointMQ feature. Remaining all will be used with any other third-party tools. But in our demo, in our demonstration and in our integration series, we are going to see ActiveMQ, which is a Apache provider, which will be available open source. So we can download it directly from Google and we can install it and we can use it. Remaining are the licensed ones. AWS SQS is also licensed one. ActiveMQ is the open source one, which we can practice it in our own way. But the process is similar to all the queues. Once you are aware of ActiveMQ queues and topics, how to use it and all, then you will be good to apply the same concepts on the remaining other JMS brokers. Okay, so let's see how we can install ActiveMQ and to set up our system. So now let's see how we can install ActiveMQ in your system and how you can set up your system. Okay. To do that, this is the URL to download the ActiveMQ executable file. So we no need to install something specifically in our system, but we need to download this archive and we need to extract it and we need to start the ActiveMQ server. I'll show you how you can do that and I can provide this URL in the description box of this video itself. Okay. So, So let's use this URL. And let's click on that. You need to just download the ActiveMQ file. You need to just click on this. Now here, based on your operating system, you need to select the one. Mine is Windows, so I can select this. And 5.616 is the latest version. So once you click on this, this zip file will get downloaded for you. So likewise, it will be get downloaded for you. You need to just extract this into some location. So I'm going to extract this under E folder, ActiveMQ, which I have already extracted it. So you can just extract it in this any folder which is flexible for you. Okay. Then now go to that particular folder where you have extracted. Okay, and here you will find a couple of folders likewise, and you need to go to the bin folder. In this bin folder, you will have this ActiveMQ admin, ActiveMQ, and all the jar files and batch files. Okay, what you have to do, you need to just go to the command prompt, click here, and type cmd. It will click on enter, it will navigate to you the command prompt. And here what you have to do, you need to just type active and tab it. Yeah, it will show you ActiveMQ hyphen admin, right? So you need to just remove the remaining thing and space start. So you need to provide ActiveMQ hyphen admin start and click on enter. It will start your admin ActiveMQ server in your local using your local host. It will take a couple of minutes. Let's wait. We need to observe and we need to get some information from here in these logs. Then we are good to configure this ActiveMQ connector in our MuleSoft. So let's wait the server to be started. Yeah, it is running. Let me maximize this. Yeah. And here the TCP one you need to remember. The TCP desktop and 61616. So this is where the broker is actually going to run. So you need to just make a note of this, where the port is 61616. And this is the desktop, I mean my laptop name. Usually we can replace it with localhost. It means like TCP colon double slash localhost colon 61616. That would be your broker URL. Also, it will show you the web console URL. It means the 8161, this is the localhost IP address, okay? So this is your ActiveMQ web console available at. So you need to wait for this message. So once you are able to see this message, then you are good to access this web console, UI, to create the queues and all, okay? So just copy these two URLs somewhere, which is handy for you. We need this information while accessing the UI and while accessing the web console and while configuring the connector. Okay, so this is the one broker URL. This is broker URL and the first one is your web console URL. Okay, but before that you need to test, you need to check for one thing. Go to your extracted folder where you have extracted. Step behind, and here you will find a configuration conf folder. So double click on that, and yeah, here you will find one XML document with ActiveMQ. Okay, just let's open it. Okay, and here this management context, you need to search for this management context, and this create connector, this value should be true. To use all the properties of this ActiveMQ, you need to just verify this. By default, it will be false. You need to change it to true. And you need to just, by default, it is like false. You need to just say change it to true, and you can just save this XML file. Okay. That is one thing you need to check. And yeah, okay, this is REST API is available here, something. Yeah, now your server is getting started. Let's access this console by replacing the IP address with the localhost. So I'm taking a new tab. So here, I just copied that URL to access the web console. Here, instead of this address, you can give localhost 8161. By default, username password is admin and admin. Okay, you can change it if you want, but just accept the defaults. So this is your console where you are going to actually create queues and where you can going to navigate the ActiveMQ console and all. So here you need to just click on manage ActiveMQ broker. It will take you to through the all the remaining menu. And here you can observe this broker name is localhost, and this is the message broker we are going to use ActiveMQ, right? So version is 5.16, and this is your ID. Uptime is 3 minutes because we have started this server 3 minutes back, so that's why it is showing 3 minutes is uptime. So you can just observe these details. That's it. We don't need these details anywhere. And here you can see the console of localhost, and this is the system name. So instead of this system name, you can use localhost because this server is running in your local machine, local laptop. Okay. So these are the ones. Here by using this queues menu we can create the queues, and by using these topics we can create the topics, and we can create the number of subscribers, and we can link that subscribers to that particular topic. Likewise, we can create all the number of queues and topics here. We will see how to create queues and topics in our next video. Okay, for now just set up this in your system. In our next video we will see how to create a queues and topics and subscribers, and how we can integrate this into your MuleSoft application. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe and share our Clap Technologies.